Intro.
You're fucking awful at doing intros. I can
Yeah,
hear
I'm just
that.
angry because it's been a month. We've already did this. Okay, message of the day. Fuck Audacity. Audacity is stupid and I hate it and I want it
It's
to fuck
not
off and
stupid,
die.
it's fine.
We already did this, but, you
New
know.
Game.
Okay, so.
New game.
Yeah, whatever. New character. We're playing Shadow Warrior 2. Well, I'm playing Shadow Warrior 2. I have no fear. Yeah, sure, that sounds fine.
That's a difficulty.
Yeah, I get that. Yeah. Okay.
Well, I didn't know if you got that.
It's supposed to be Nathan's turn, but the audio was recording the game instead of our voices, so we're going to have to do that later. Probably a month from now, so you're getting another month-long wait. Eddie Key. So tell me about Shadow Warrior 2.
It's made by Flying Wild Hog. And
is it published by Devolver Digital? Oh, how did I fucking know? Those trees look weird. Why do they just end like that? Trees don't do that.
It's because they're cursed trees.
Oh, good, this game actually does have subtitles.
Yeah, because it's not some retarded game like Resident
Evil.
Yeah,
we'll get
4.
To that. We'll get to that. And his name is Wang, because this game is made for children. But that's fine. I never played the first Shadow Warrior, or the original Shadow Warrior. Does it still have that weird, like, thing with anime girls?
No.
Okay.
I don't think the original had that either.
Yeah, the original apparently had a very weird attitude towards women.
Wasn't that every game?
Well, yeah, that's fair. But it was a bit... Oh, that was a rabbit fucking another rabbit. That's lovely. Oh, I don't want to skip this cutscene. Oh, okay. Of course he doesn't give a shit. Because then...
It's playing
it
You Got the
bad.
Touch. Just right now, so I don't know how the copyright's gonna go down.
You got
that.
The touch! Sorry. So... Anyway, how you been, Nathan? That's the 50th time I've had to ask you this weekend.
Alright.
It's holidays. Don't think that means we'll be doing more of these. We're lazy fuckers. Fuck off, okay. Alright, he threw his booze. I got a katana. And I got a pistol and a machine gun. That's lovely. Sorry.
You got your weapon.
So I just had a Coke, so I'm a bit fizzy. Okay.
You know I typically do the burping, right?
Yeah, well, I'm angry right now, so... Oh, so it's got Minecraft sprints.
Yeah.
Might as well just do this.
Yeah, I don't know why you're not.
And double jump. This is setting itself up well now. Oh boy.
No, I fell off a cliff.
I did fall off a cliff. Oh wait. Yeah, that makes sense. That's how climbing works, folks. Yeah, why wouldn't you just always dash?
I do. I don't know why
that's. Does that cost mana?
No.
Huh. Weird. You know, I wish more games would let you do the control settings that, you know, double tapping something did something. Because then you could... Oh, it's a pig. It's a little piglet. So, what's your experience with this game, then?
So far, it's pretty good. It's been a cool mix of the reboot of Shadow Warrior, which I thought was just kind of eh.
Okay.
I only reason I got the second one, because I was like, oh, yeah. I was like, oh, that game came out.
Have you ever watched Kill Bill?
No.
You'd probably like that. What are these called? Fang. Fang and Wang. Is that...
Fangs.
Yeah. I wonder why they're called that. Is it because of their lovely smiles?
It's because they've got big teeth, Connor.
Oh, okay. I thought you were supposed to be... This is so unrealistic. This statue should be cut in half right now. 0 out of 10.
Stop being unentertaining, Connor.
I'm just... We did this already, and now I'm angry. Alright, fine, let's talk about a topic. Give me a topic. It's your responsibility now.
I don't know. We're going to do the same topics from,
Okay, I found out...
from Resident Evil, or...?
Might as well. I found out that, Nathan hasn't watched The Dark Knight, and he likes Batman. What the fuck's up with that?
He's never got around to watching it.
Why not?
I just never got around to it. It's as simple as that. What? I never went to set... I've never bought it on DVD. Download it, so there. There's your answer.
It's been out for a few years now.
I don't care.
I think the studio's okay with you, like, you know, streaming it now.
Yeah, I don't have any, like, streaming shit.
No, I mean, just, you know... Okay, I'm gonna use the I word here, illegally.
That's illegal.
You're right, it is illegal, and I can respect
Crash,
you.
You're fucking shit at this game, Cute. I'll give you that.
It's my first time, that's the point of the series, you wang.
The opening section.
Oh wait, no, I've got guns. Okay, I think I figured this game out. Oh, it's reloading. Fuck off. So this game's alright so far.
Oh no, there's reloading, a mechanic that like every game with gun has had, and you know.
No, Doom never had it, and people think that's the best thing ever because it is. Doom. The new Doom doesn't have reloading because the new Doom kicks ass.
Lol. He thinks the new Doom's good. What a retard.
Fuck you, everybody loves the new Doom.
The only reason people like the new Doom is because it has Doom in the name.
Dog, please.
Yeah, this is pretty much it.
No, it's really not.
Had they called it any other thing, I'd be like, oh yeah, that's alright, it's pretty good.
No, it's people would have been, that was badass. I'll grant you that about Painkiller, but that was because that was made by a relatively unknown studio and had a very minimal marketing budget. I don't think I've even seen a trailer for that game. Although I typically tend to avoid trailers for games.
Games should have demos and movies.
No, I avoid them for movies as well because I just don't like trailers because it's just marketing. And I wouldn't just go out of my way to watch an advert, would you?
No, well, if I want to know more about a product, what's the other way I can do it?
Well, who tells the truth about products? The guys who want you to buy it, or you know, literally anybody else?
Well, yeah, no, you go into trailers thinking, oh yeah, this is probably going to be the best bit, so if these are pretty shit, then chances are what they're selling me is going to be absolutely garbage. Oh,
basically, you'd be surprised how well marketers can make something shit sound good. Like, so Naughty Bear.
Like, look at that.
Oh, boy.
Everyone's like, wow, look how shit the new Ghostbusters trailer was. And
oh, it was a shit trailer, though, to be fair.
What a surprise. So
it wasn't that bad.
No, the movie wasn't that bad.
The trailer was way worse than the movie. I'd rather rewatch the movie than rewatch the trailer. That trailer was atrocious. Although, you know, it wasn't too long.
I'm surprised. Bill Murray actually went in.
Yeah, he's a bit completely disconnected from reality, Bill Murray. He doesn't like doing things nowadays. It kind of, although it reminds me of a story. You know, Dune, right? The book. The sci-fi book?
No.
Well, they've tried to make it into a movie a few times, and like,
they want Bill Murray to do it?
No. But they're... one time, a guy called Jodorowsky was trying to get together a cast for it. H.G. Wells, I think. No, that's a writer. Wells. Orson Welles, that's it. You know of Orson Welles, right?
No.
Fat dude. Anyway, you want to know how they convinced them to act for the movie? The guy met Orson Welles at a bakery, and he just said, I will hire this chef to make cakes for you forever, or whatever it was. And he said, basically, all right. And you want to know something? That's how you get someone who basically has all the money they need to do a job. Stuff like that. Just, here, now you have cakes. I like cakes. Do you like cakes?
Yeah, they're all right. If someone told me that, that's a very strange, like, offer to do a movie, I probably wouldn't have done it. I've been way too sus.
Well, no, Jodorowsky is, like, an actual dude. He's not, like, an unknown. He's a very odd man, Jodorowsky, though. He got a 14-year-old son to play, like, the main character in that movie, who'd had no acting experience, and the role required a lot of, like, working out and shit, and that guy was 14 years old. Didn't we just come from the car?
Yeah.
Did we circle round?
Yeah.
I didn't even notice. Alright.
Well, level design is that good.
No, actually, I think we'll find that means that the level design is so identical to each other that it all looked the same to me, so I didn't notice when I was actually looking at the same things.
Well, I mean, you didn't, like, it was a circle, you didn't...
I'm just being a dick, it's fine.
Yeah, I was just making sure you realised
it is very pretty, this game.
It was a circle, like, you wouldn't just...
You know what it reminds me of just looking at it? Bioshock Infinite, from the colours in that.
I think it's on the same engine. I think it's on Unreal.
Probably.
So
I like the Unreal
same landing engine.
Oh, I really want to cut this dude's head off.
I'm pretty sure.
Oh fuck off! Oh wait. Okay, he's just the invincible bodyguard. Where can I get me one of these guys?
Because these are just like you're not actually. You're just meant to talk to someone here and get a gun.
Yay, guns. Well, I remember the opening to the first game, you basically talk to a guy about getting a sword, and then he tries to kill you.
Yeah, this is not it.
Identical. So, did you play the first Shadow Warrior?
Yeah, I never finished it, but played it.
Did you like that? Oh, fucking hell. That cannot be comfortable. And that can... No, hey, it's Deathstroke. It's Deathstroke if he was Deadpool. Well, which he basically is. And it's the... chick from Dishonored 2.
Yeah.
Except Chinese.
Emily Coldwyn.
Yeah, talk about that. Talk about Dishonored 2. You want to get that game, don't
you? Yeah, I'm going to get it. I'm probably going to get it.
During the Christmas sale?
Well, I mean, if it only goes down like 15%, because Bethesda are very, dare I say the word, Jewish. They'll only put it down 15%. So, like they did for Fallout 4.
Yeah, I got Fallout 4 during the sale because it was half off and I didn't think it would go that cheap for a long time.
But the Christmas sale was coming on.
It
was either going to go just as cheap or more.
But admittedly, it was kind of a non-thinking purchase. Because I was considering getting Just Cause 3, which looks fucking great, by the way.
Yeah, I showed a bit of it to him today.
Explosions!
You should have got Just Cause
3. Yeah, but the reason that I didn't get it is because you keep telling me I won't be able to run it on my cheese of a computer.
You won't. Well, it'll be another Doom thing where we'll just say you're not even launching
the game. I haven't told the Doom story yet.
Oh yeah, tell the Doom story, how you were so excited all that time to download all 50 gigs.
I bought Doom because I figured, oh, this is game of the year material right here. And then it just didn't run. It wouldn't even let me look at the main menu. Oh, cool.
Yeah, there's a mini map up there.
You should
go and claim your reward.
Claim my. So basically, in the context of this game, what I just did was leave the office and then come straight back just to go back in there. I've got. Is that a portal reference?
I don't know.
That feels like a portal.
You gotta like enter.
Enter. Oh, okay.
You're the whore.
So immediately after Civ 5, we're back to staring at people. Talking to us with a big menu next to him.
Mm-hmm.
Lovely. We're not doing a big one, by the way, again. Oh, it's a double barrel. I just realized what I got. It's a shotgun. This will be fun. Okay.
You can get a double barrel.
Don't take this personally, but I just need to know. Fuck's sake. Where did you get these guys?
Just wait until there's like an actual enemy you can use.
I can't wait. That's why I wanted to get Doom. There's no waiting in that game. The action starts and never stops.
Actually, there's cutscenes in that game.
Yeah, but they're quick. At least from what I've heard. I don't like the glory kill system. Actually, it's not too bad from what I've seen. At least they're quick, so that's what I like.
Some of them are.
They seem a bit too easy to get. You just get them low health. And you do it, and that's kind of lame. Should be like Resident Evil 4, where you have to shoot them in the face of the leg. And then you can do the prompts. A bit harder to get in... RE4. Oh, oops. Fucking hell. What the hell happened? I know we don't typically listen to the cutscenes, but this looks like a fucking... Is that a robot arm? No.
There are robots. There's robot sex dolls that didn't sell very well, apparently, so they're using them as angry attack robots.
You know how sex robots are like sci-fi right now? Cell phones used to be sci-fi a long time ago, and now it's not. So I'm kind of hoping that one day we do get sex bots. Although, if I'm being honest, I'd probably be scared of it. Put your penis in my were vagina. Do not take away my purpose. Fulfill my purpose. Fucking were vaginas.
You're not very good at following where you're meant to go.
Yeah, I can't, because I just want to shoot things.
But you ran away from the enemies.
Yeah.
So even that's a
they're
lie.
They're blending in. They're blending in with the background.
They're floating fucking balls.
Yeah, they're floating balls. This is like
they even have little lights that go around.
See,
them.
The reason why the floating balls worked in Doom is because they had faces and were noisy and would actually shoot, you know, just big balls, not little missiles. And they had, like, at least a semblance of personality to them. What were they called? Pain Elementals, or...?
Yeah, Pain Elemental, I think that was what they were called.
There were a few Elementals in that game, if I remember correctly. It's been a while since I played Doom, although I did get Doom, the BFG edition, recently.
Is it the big fucking gun edition, or big fucking game edition?
Both. I used to call Serious Sam 3 BFE Serious Sam 3 before First a Gun. Oh, wait, no, It's before First Encounter, but I just called it, Big Fucking E-Gun. Oh, actually, here's an interesting bit of trivia, for you. You remember in the first Half-Life where there was that gun that you'd get before you'd go to Zen, and it was, like, it had the backpack on it?
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
Yeah, that in the game's files, that's called the E-Gun, after E-Gon from Ghostbusters.
Hmm.
Which is kind of cool.
Cut it.
Fucking hell. Oh, yes, give me that.
Because when you switch to your sword, when you're in combat, the first thing, when you switch to it, it'll do a slice.
Is there a quick button for a sword?
Yeah, the one button.
Oh, okay.
Well, you can press G and it'll switch back to your previous weapon.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Fair enough.
There's looting in here as well. You can open up chests and you can get stuff.
I don't care.
So you can get cool little...
I'm not stopping the action for the sake of loot. I just want to stab things.
So you can get, like, upgrades. So you can make your sword or gun shoot fire or electricity or something like that. Whatever.
Swords don't shoot.
I don't know. You can cut electricity or some shit. You can cut with electric.
Cut with electric, yes. Cut with electric dreams. Sorry.
There's an enemy there.
Yes! No.
He just blocked you. He blocked the headshot. How do you like that?
No,
it's not very fun, is it?
Because
it's a terrible mechanic.
Yeah, melee in first person. I'm basically just playing Genji right now. With my ult always on. Okay. So, let's talk about Bat Arkham again. I played Arkham Asylum recently.
You want me to rate what I think are the best ones again?
Well, I already know what you're gonna say.
Yeah, but the viewers.
Yeah, the viewers.
The viewers, huh?
You wanna be dicks and just fuck you, viewers. You don't get to know. His favorite's Arkham Knight. It's the best one.
Yeah. No, it's Arkham Origins.
That one had the best villains. Yeah.
Yeah.
Except Joker. Joker was shit. I liked Firefly.
Firefly was... Oh, yeah,
he was. I remember, because that's my go-to shit villain.
With Firefly.
He's a fucking, like, guy with a Firefly. Because the best Batman villains reflect an aspect of Batman back at him. What does Firefly represent? Oh, I say that, but what does Poison Ivy represent? His supple buttocks.
I don't know. His playboy attitude?
He's
now
not a playboy. The playboy attitude's fake. If anything, he's a
stoic monk.
Yeah, he never has sex. He never allows himself the privilege. What happens if I press Q?
That's your Healy.
Good.
Switch to the shotgun.
Oh, yeah,
pussy.
I thought I was. Sword, shotgun there, boom. Gah! Invisible. Gah! Gah!
Admittedly, I think the area's in Zilla's area, so like this is like the, you know, like neon bit. I think that's some of the worst.
Boop!
The poorer ones.
I do like killing poor people, though.
Well, I mean, these are fucking cyborg ninjas.
So it's kind of like Deus Ex if it had no subtlety whatsoever.
Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. You played, have we talked about the demo for System Shock?
Oh, yeah!
You've never played a System Shock
life. If they manage to complete that, I'll play that. That's cool.
Honestly, I'm surprised they didn't just do System Shock 2 though, because that's the one everybody talks about. It's the one I like. System Shock 1, nobody talks about System Shock 1. I mean, it was fine. It was okay. It wasn't as good. It was, System Shock 2 was way better, though.
Turn around.
I want the glowing thing. Give me the glowing thing. Key, fine. What'd you like? What was it specifically that made you go, yes, this is me?
What?
Well, what about it appealed to you so much?
Well, I mean, for starters, the combat had good reactions, like when it hit someone.
Yeah, that wasn't like, in the original System Shock. Like,
felt like I was actually hitting someone. Oh yeah, this is the part where she gets a demon put in her.
Oh, cool. So, it's kind of like rape.
Yeah, kind of.
I do like rape. Moving on, I don't like rape, viewers. Oh, by the way, that's something I
want... Oh, here we go.
I want to clarify. I'm not actually racist. I say the N-word a lot on this thing, but I'm not actually racist. I feel I should point this out now, because this is a very racial game, let's just say. So, I've got nothing against anyone of African-American, Asian, stop playing with my iPad descent. Just getting that out of the way. Now, anyway, nigga, bitch. Anyway, what?
Why don't you want me playing with your iPad?
Because you'll lock it for 5 hours. I know your pattern.
Can you let me look through your Safari data retention history?
I delete my history, you dickface. You never know who's going to just...
Can I critique you on what porn you watch?
I delete all my porn. You never know who's going to go stumbling through your history, especially since I live with my sister. So, yeah.
Do you reckon your sister would be disgusted in you?
No, because she's found stuff in the past.
Has she?
Yeah.
What she found?
She never mentioned specifics.
But she says she's found stuff.
Well, it's come up. She's offhandedly mentioned it once. Just to
has she mentioned specifics?
No, she hasn't. You never listen to me.
No, I don't.
Well, I'm talking about porn. I thought you liked it when I talk about porn.
Yeah, because it's always funny, because you always just do it, like, so blatantly.
It's great. Because it's just porn. Porn is like video games. It's... everybody under 40 plays it, but there's still a weird stigma around it for some reason.
Like the average game. Lest I use that fucking word.
I don't like the word gamer either, but yeah, fair enough.
Yeah,
people who play video games.
Yeah, what's it called? Isn't like the average one like 30 or something?
Oh, yeah, I think it's 29 the last time I checked. Something like that.
Oh, okay.
I like revolvers. I've shot a revolver once, that was fun.
I have. I've done that.
Although, admittedly, the semi-automatic felt more natural in my hand. There's something a bit unwieldy about the revolver, but I think that kind of adds to its appeal, you know?
Yeah, I like the revolver more than
and
the
it was
semi.
Much more powerful. It
had fucking fire coming out of it.
Yeah.
That's the seller right there. You write that in the box. Bitch has got fire coming out of it. Huh?
Boop.
You got that in your little pussy-ass Glock? No, I don't.
So there is iron sights, okay.
Yeah, there is. But
I thought it was going to shoot two... Oh, wait, no, this isn't a double barrel shotgun. It's kind of reminding me of Ziggurat, except without the spells. I don't know why. I think it's because the enemies I just kind of find meh.
And just kind of float around.
And Well, at least there's no motion blur in this, like Ziggurat had.
Yeah.
You
motion blurs are cancer.
People like that? No, I'm low on ammo for that. Okay.
It only works when people are trying to mask their 30 frames per second that they,
Hey, I usually have less than 30 frames per second. I don't use motion blur. Give me a headache just looking at it. It doesn't make me motion sick. I've only gotten motion sick once, and that was playing, the Aliens campaign in AVP, in Aliens vs. Predator, because you go around walls in that game at the speed of light, and it fucking hurts.
I've never gotten motion sickness.
Yeah, it's not nice, but you know, I just stared at a wall for 15 minutes, and I was fine.
I've never played that game. Connor, you should get me to do it.
Yeah, but I don't want to do that, because then it'll be a bit derivative when we do the good shit Aliens game.
Is that the game you have planned that you keep mentioning?
No, because I've mentioned that to you before.
Ugh.
At some point, we're going to do AVP. No, Aliens.
Colonial Marines.
Colonial Marines.
Why do people say the like Colonial Marines thing like that? What that happened
with it was Randy
Pitchford?
Because he lied about it.
Yeah, no. But like with what's his name? Fuck, with the next thing, Battleborn's karma.
Because Randy Pitchford never owned up. He acted like whenever people brought it up, he acted like he was the one being bullied and like he's the white knight that rose from the ashes of bullying and shit, when really he's the asshole who lied about his stupid fucking video game that was shit. Why do these ninjas keep disappearing? Ninjas don't disappear. That's inaccurate. Yeah,
they do. Ninjas disappear all the time.
Batman Begins was a good fucking movie. Dark Knight Rises, I thought it was better, but then I watched it recently and it wasn't as good as I remember it being. I found it boring in places, and I thought the ending was a bit weak sauce.
What, the nuke?
It just felt a bit unnecessary. I will admit there was a closing to the arc of Batman, but other than that, I mean, the fact that he's alive in Italy for just stupid reasons just annoys me. I did like it when
what the fuck is that?
I don't know.
There's 90 weapons.
Oh, in this game, gross! Right? It's what's it called? The game that I keep ragging on. Oh hey.
Hey, you got another one as well.
Whatever. I'll just assume it's better.
There's no straight upgrades. There's no straight upgrades though.
Oh well. Anyway, so yeah, and though I did like Catwoman, I thought she was cool because she's like poor, and this is about poor people rising up from the ashes and all that lovely stuff.
She doesn't end up siding with
Yeah, she does. Yeah, does he starts out with Batman. Yeah, no, and she saves him.
You didn't even let me finish then.
I assume that's what you were going to say. What were you going to say?
I was going to say, she doesn't end up siding with, what's his face?
Bane? Bane. Yeah. When do you not know Bane's name?
Bane.
You meme lord. Fucking hate stupid
just
skip names.
This. This is just her. Oh, yeah, she tries to bite him because she's possessed by him.
Because she's a zombie for some reason. Oh, boo.
And then he, we're recording.
It's okay. Oh, I'm gonna shut the door quickly.
It fell for a bit. Why? We're gonna delete this bit anyway.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. Sorry. It's technical shit. Anyway, doesn't matter. Blah. Say, remember, what were we saying? You're saying mentioning something? No, whatever.
Just keep going.
I played the pacifist.
It wasn't good anyway.
I played the pacifist run in, and the genocide run in Undertale, finally. I played, the neutral run, like, eons ago, and thought, yeah, it was good. It was good. And then I did the pacifist ending, but if you don't do the pacifist ending on your first run, it doesn't tell you the extra steps you need to do to get the, like, uber good ending. So, I never got around to it until I looked into it. And, yeah.
Oh, look at that. It's the Wang Cave.
The Wang Cave. By the way, you know how you tease it for being Tumblr-y and I said it's not even really all that Tumblr-y?
You actually looked into the fan base?
No. I know the fan base is Tumblr-y, but, you know, that's not a measure of the game. That's a measure of the people. But,
You know, that complaint only holds up for single-player games, because when you say the community's bad in a multiplayer game like League of Legends, it's absolutely complaint.
That's fair.
And you got the chainsaw.
Although it is easy to just ignore people. Oh, I thought it was going to be like, cut through the door.
No.
Yeah, no, that does have a few... Well, it does have a few more Tumblr-y elements, I guess you could say, when you get through the pacifist ending, but, it's still fine, still a good game, although you'd find it obnoxious for reasons I don't fully understand. Can I cut this?
No.
And the genocide run made me feel like absolute shit, and that's why Just Cause 3 appealed to me, because there's no consequences, and that was the theme of, the genocide run, is that you thought there was no consequences, and guess what? Your actions have meaning. You dickbag.
He's Hideo.
He looks edgy as shit.
His name's Hideo.
What's his last name?
I don't know.
Hideo Mojima. Mojita. Mojita. Fucking... Oh, no, I don't care. Leave me alone.
Skip that shit, boy.
Oh, thanks. Oh, he gave me a reward. It's like Dark Souls. You talk to people. Oh, it's oh, hey. All right. That's kind of cool, I guess.
Press I. I think it's I, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Now click weapons.
Weapons.
You and after sword. Pick out your favorite, boy. That one. Damage resist 75% for 10 seconds on 2 simultaneously kills.
Oh, Lil Wang. That's the lesser sword. That's the sword I have now, right?
No, you don't have that equipped now. You've got blades of zibat, stuff of the blah.
Ah, okay. I'll use that then. Blah.
Yeah, that's how you put gems on it and make it better.
Yeah, give just whatever. I don't
just
care.
Just go equipped.
Equipped.
Yeah.
What?
Equipped menu up the top.
Oh. Equipped.
There you go. Yeah. So there you go. That's where all your weapons it. Are. What keys they're on.
Great. Whatever. Oh, hello. Oh, dead. Oh, these are good guys.
Yeah.
Yay, this is dancing. Ah, oh, there's ammo on that. That's bullshit. Whatever. I don't care. What do you think about chainsaws in games? What's your favorite chainsaw in games?
This one.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Because it has, like, physics where... It in the... Well, will we get to that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or if you just fucking go into the...
All right.
Will, actually.
I don't like the objectives in this game.
Just because you can't see them?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, just because you're blind?
Where is the objectives?
You talk to him.
Oh, okay. Well, it doesn't have a thing on him. Blech.
It does. You just, like, came behind him.
You should always be careful when you...
Master Smith, if you don't cure someone.
Yeah, whatever.
It already... Spoiler alert, it does.
It... What does? What does
body
what?
Becomes corrupted.
Oh, lovely. Is it fun when that happens?
Well, you, the fun things happen? Boss fight.
Do you kill her?
I don't kill her more. No, because... Because she gets possessed by the demon, and then it's like... Hey,
actually,
man,
I don't
just,
care.
It's just her body,
what's,
so...
Yeah. What's your favourite anime?
I hate anime.
I know you do. That's why I asked.
My favorite anime is...
Is this game.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't watch a lot of anime either, as you well know. Oh, okay, guns and stuff. What are you buying, stranger?
An AR-53. He'll get more guns as you go through the story.
I don't have a lot of... Wait, I do have a lot of...
You got 25,000.
Is that
bombs.
A lot? Should I bother?
No.
Okay, I'm out. Come back later, dick face. Oh. Anyway, so, yeah. What would make you give Undertale another shot?
Why do you want me to give Undertale another shot?
Because I reckon that you'd like it if you just, you know, gave it a chance. I mean, admittedly, some of the characters I feel that you would find annoying, like Papyrus.
I did. The first time I saw him, I was like, this is annoying. Yeah. He is annoying. I'm going to kill him.
I
already knew about the whole if you kill people, they stay dead thing, so I was really proud when he died.
You killed him, you jerk. You cut his head off.
Yeah,
he's the only innocent thing in the game.
No, he's not. He tries to capture you. He's a cunt.
Well, yeah, but... only because he's misunderstood.
For once,
you murdered him! That's not law-abiding.
I'm the law-abiding citizen, and he...
Wait a minute, you hate foreigners! You were the foreigner!
No.
You racist.
I own that country. They're underground, so technically they're still in my country.
Well, they were a bit...
Open the mission map and travel to Shadow Hills.
Where? How? What
press
button?
Press I.
I.
And go...
Missions. Start.
Then you teleport.
Oh, and then I Reaper out of here.
Yeah, you Reaper out of here.
Reaper. Anyway.
So this is the podcast episode where we're just jaded the entire time.
I'm just annoyed because the other one was fine.
Yeah, but why'd you have to start getting annoyed now? Why couldn't you be all happy like you were when we were watching me play Just Cause
3? Yay! Let's talk about Just Cause 3 then.
Oh, Just Cause 3.
What's your favorite explosion?
The train one.
Yay! The train explodes. Why aren't we playing Just Cause 3?
Because...
I haven't played it before.
No. I'm going to hold that one off just like the Dark Souls one.
I fucking hate you. Well, it's not like I'm going to buy Just Cause 3 anytime soon. I already own Dark Souls 2. Right now, the only thing that's keeping me from playing it is this series. You're fucking welcome, by the way, viewers. Not that you care. You'd love to see me suffer, wouldn't you? I hate my viewers. Yeah. Just kidding. I secretly love all of you. Except Derek. Fuck Derek. I don't know any Dereks.
I don't like Jacob.
I think he's a cunt. Actually, if there's someone... Like, no. Actually, hang on, we already know half
of our... Do we know a Jacob? I don't know a Jacob.
No, I don't know either. I know half of our subscriber base is one person. Yeah, thanks, retard.
It's gonna be funny, like, if we somehow get popular, and it's like 50 billion people now feel special. Dickbags. They're not
special. Well, supposedly, the way the YouTube algorithm works is series is never going to get popular, unless everyone's watching the entire hour.
Well, a few people do. By the way, we're never doing a long one again. Fuck you all, that was infuriating. But we didn't check when we started this, didn't we?
No.
Well, I think we started around 2:30, I think, so I'll just go by that. Anyway, yeah. You don't care, viewers, I'm assuming. What the hell's him? He looks like a Sun and Moon
He's
Pokemon.
A superior Tauro. He's like a normal Tauro, but superior.
That's the name of a Pokemon.
Tauro?
Yeah, it's like a bull one. From Gen 2.
Use the chainsaw, you cock.
You wanted to talk about Nintendo. Do you want to talk about Nintendo again?
Yes, this is a PSA, public service announcement.
Oh, boy.
Everyone stop sucking Nintendo.
Everybody stop and listen to what Nathan has to say. Oh, lovely.
Fuck him up. Yeah. Swipe. Ah!
Ah. Ah. His legs are off. Oh, boy. Bits. Meat. Ah, oh, lovely meat. I do like meat.
You know how when, like, in a normal game, we just default gore, they explode and they go into lots of
little
bits?
It'd be like
bits.
A little mini cutscene, almost.
Yeah, this one, you do it.
Yeah.
The power behind the player is you.
Don't say it like
the power that. Behind... What the fuck was that? Found a demonic rod. Is that a dick?
Hold E to start.
That's a chat, you don't want
to. Oh, okay, gross. Yeah, get the anime girl away.
Cold eye. I want to see what the demonic rod is.
Hold on. Boop.
Oh yeah, if you hold right click, it just does a normal like thing, so you can just glide it around.
Anyway, the last episode for the Batman Telltale series came out the other day.
Oh yeah.
Do you care about that at all?
No. The only Telltale I care about is
The Walking Dead and The Wolf Among Us.
I never played The Wolf Among Us.
Really?
It's good though.
Yeah, I mean it is based on a comic.
I want to see what the demonic rod is. Press
weapons.
You gotta there. No. It's not a weapon. What the fuck?
Upgrades.
Demonic rod.
Is it a penis thing? Nah. Cool for medic? No.
Alright, well...
Wanglopedia.
Yeah, that's where all the
kill me.
Weapons are.
Kill me. I want to die. This makes me want to commit seppuku.
The Wanglopedia.
Yes.
Well, there's a thing there. There's a golden token.
Oh.
Golden charm. So you can put it on one of your guns and make it better.
I'm sure that has some interesting like background history that we could talk about now if we had any semblance of intelligence.
Well, no, so you're like half the game you're missing because you don't do the gem customization.
Fuck gem customization.
So, you know,
boring.
You can make your guns like min max all of your guns. So, oh, I shoot a rabbit. Hang on, there's a rabbit in that bush, by the way.
Where? What kinda bush?
On the minimap, that green dot.
Oh, okay.
Somewhere.
Oh,
there.
Ah.
Kill it.
Fuck you. Ah! Rabbits in video games. Rabbits in video games. Your theory was sound. Ah. Oh, wait, no, that was with chickens.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Now it's rabbits.
Rabbits and chickens. And foxes, oh my. Lions and bears and tigers, they're fine. Fucking easy.
Yeah.
Except in fucking Far Cry 3, I hated those bastards. So was it Far Cry 3?
I think I thought we'll web it. Got the achievement unlock. I think I thought we'll web it.
What do you think of Looney Tunes?
I don't know, the only Looney Tunes I think I've actually watched
is Back in Action.
Yeah, Back in Action.
I watched that a lot as a kid too. It's not
Tunes,
it's not as good as
The Blue Monkey.
The Blue Monkey.
I still remember that.
Yeah, and I remember how they undress.
They're dead.
Oh, okay.
Don't they undress?
No, they like zipper into other people, like they're...
Oh, yeah!
He was one of the basketball players at one point. And I don't know, there's something just dumb about Brandon Fraser that I just appreciate whenever he's in a role. Except in sequels. No, I don't want to just shoot more rabbits, I'll shoot this eyeball. Jesus, fuck, that was a eyeball.
That was a rabbit on the ground you could have shot.
I'm not shooting the rabbits. They've done that... Look, it's...
You died.
Oh. Oh. Okay. Anyway. You want to talk about Looney Tunes back in action?
Yeah, let's keep going. Okay, let's examine the plot.
Okay, yeah, let's do that. Let's make this exam hour.
Alright. It begins with a,
Well, how does it begin?
From memory, it begins with that, like, film noir.
Yeah, that's right.
With, like, Bugs taking a shower.
No, that's later. That's when he's when the sexy lady goes into the dude's house.
To
get his job back or whatever it was. Yeah. Oh, yeah, and then there's the bit where they go to Vegas.
Yeah.
And the weird, like, Yosemite dance thing. That was odd.
I don't remember that.
Well, there was, like, a Dixie something or other, and there's, like, a bunch of, like, midgets dressed up as Yosemite Sam who dance on stage as backup dancers. It was very odd.
I need to see this movie.
I do like that sort of style of, like, having cartoons in real life in the same thing. It's a shame that most of them turn out shit, though.
Who Framed Roger Rabbit did that as well?
No, yeah, that's the one exception.
Holy fuck.
That's a... Okay.
Superior talent. He's got a lot of health.
I've got a lot of bullets. I thought he was fucked. Okay. Boss fight. Some music would be nice. I'm sure there's lots of it, but I can't hear it.
When you piss off the rabbits, a whole bunch of heavy metal plays.
Of course. I did hear heavy metal when we were loading this game up. What do you think of heavy metal?
Not really that much of a fan. I could probably get into it if I like had like a slow progression, like, you know, to, like, just like, you know, light metal, then some metal, and then probably
up. I do like progression in music. That's why I like power ballads.
No, I was more thinking as a genre, so I could get used to it.
Yeah.
It's like album to album, some kind of deal.
Well, AC/DC is like where most people start their metal, you know, phase.
A new Metallica album came out, actually.
They still make music?
Yeah.
I know AC/DC's do, but they're fucking old at this point. Ah! A friend of mine went to go see them live, apparently that was fun. And it was on the train, and it was basically old, just people in AC/DC shirts, like old, bearded, like middle-aged people in AC/DC t-shirts. So that's fun. What kind of dad do you think you'd be?
Kenny.
No, you're not that nice.
Kenny?
Oh, wait, no, Kenny's okay. A bit of an arsehole. Yeah, no, I just... Look, I like him up into the point where he gets on my back for not agreeing with him that we should kill some helpless pensioner to...
Why didn't you want to kill the pensioner?
Because, I mean, it wasn't going to help matters, it was just murder.
How was it not going to help matters? He was dying, he was going to turn into a zombie, and then you're going to have to fight him as a zombie.
Well, it's...
That's what Kenny said, like...
Well, it's not that quick. We had shit to do. Well, if we could have bludgeoned him when he was a zombie, when we were sure. I mean, the last time he had a spaz attack, he was fine later. We just had to give him some medicine.
Yeah, you couldn't get medicine in there.
Yeah, but he was sitting up and just blabbering to himself, and he'd say, fuck you if you talk to him. So he was fine. He wasn't dead. He was just having a bit of a spasm.
He passed out in that one, though.
Yeah.
So we didn't know the extent of how bad it was.
I mean, don't get me wrong. The guy was an asshole, but, I mean, he still wanted to murder him. Be fair. Murder isn't right if you just don't like the guy.
Well, no, it's right because it's saving the rest of the group because he's going to turn into a 6-foot animal.
We could have bludgeoned him then.
No, you couldn't have.
Wait, Kenny okay, right. did you opt to say to like defend Duck?
Wait, what?
Like in the when you first go into the drugstore, were you fighting for Kenny that we shouldn't kill Duck?
Well, yeah,
because
I knew.
Then you're a hypocrite because no, that's the same thing.
Duck wasn't bitten.
You didn't know that. He was covered in muck. You didn't know he was bit or not.
Well, put it this way: you just clean it off, and you'll find out. We actually didn't know if he was dead or not, and Duck, you could just clean up and find out. I'm not a hypocrite, and that's a retarded point.
No, you're just angry because you're wrong.
Yeah, so, okay, there we go. Just you lose the argument, then it's just, oh, you're wrong.
I like The Walking Dead.
Yeah, it's good. It's a good game.
Yeah, good game. Jinx, or whatever.
Some people don't call them games, and I partially agree with it, because...
Well, that's what games used to be.
Choices don't really mean much.
Once upon a time, all games were adventure games, like Space Quest and what have you. King's Quest. I didn't like King's Quest, although I thought Space Quest was kind of fun. You should play... you wouldn't like adventure games.
No, I wouldn't.
Because they're kind of gameplay deficient, which is fair. But there are a few good ones, like The Secret of Monkey Island's a classic, which I'm sure you've heard of but never played.
I've heard of it.
You can double jump.
Screenshots and
it's fun. Yeah, I like the insult fight.
Insult fight.
Yeah, there's a bit where you
There was a multiplayer game based off of an insult fight, and then I never understood how it worked. And I was like,
well, just give the correct insult back. Give the
no, but it's just kind of like you get a whole bunch of cards, and they're just like work adjectives.
Oh, so kind of like Cards Against Humanity, but with insults.
Yeah. But the thing is, there's no, like, person who decides what's funny or not, what's a good insult.
It's I kind of feel like...
So I wasn't really sure how it worked, and it really didn't look that fun.
Looking back on Cards Against Humanity, it really does have that issue where a lot of the responses just aren't funny. But, you know, then again...
Gotta have some shit cards in there.
Yeah, I always get the shit cards. Can't stand it. Like, and I always use my best one right before you get a Harry Potter one. Those always gave the best results. Harry Potter and the Secrets of Cum. Something like that. There's a game called Whiplash, which is good for that, because it's Cards Against Humanity, except you choose your responses, you type it out. I kind of prefer that, because there's a bit more creativity to it. And it can, you know, based on the kind of people you play with, the style of humor changes, because, you know, you could either be... like playing with really Australian people who use the word cunt a lot and pretend to be bogans, or you could be playing with the more sophisticated brand of comedians who...
Bunch of losers.
Yeah, bunch of losers. I do like a good dumb joke. Although...
I can't believe you thought that Harry Potter and the Secrets of Cum was funny.
He's
the only
not,
good type of humor he's is not, the faulty towers.
He's not the Messiah. He's a very naughty boy.
That movie, you tell you what, the movie was all right, but honestly, I don't see how that movie was like hailed as the greatest like comedy ever. It was just kind of like, it was all right. It wasn't anything fantastic.
It was, I disagree with you wholeheartedly. I was pissing myself at a few of them.
I laughed once.
I want to rewatch that, because it's been ages since I've watched any of the Monty Python movies. I still haven't watched The Meaning of Life, which is like the third one. Which, although I've seen bits of it, and it was quite fun. John Cleese is going to be dead soon, which is a bit of a shame. I like John Cleese. Your thoughts on John Cleese? What's your favorite stand-up comedian?
I don't really have a favorite stand-up comedian. I don't really watch him. I find them very hit and miss. Like, I watch one of them. Like, I'll see one of their videos on Facebook, and then I'm like, oh yeah, that's kind of funny.
I'll get them off Facebook.
And then I see, like, I go in and try and look at their work. I'm like, wait, he really isn't funny at all.
Well, if you watch some if you just watch some decent panel shows, you'll typically find some people you like. Love a good panel show. Like, what's it called? Would I Lie to You? That's it. That's a good one. Mock the Week. That one's fun. Frankie Boyle's great. I like him. He's got a brilliant Scottish accent. You like a good Scottish accent, don't you?
Yeah. Those fucking Call of Duty videos of the Scottish people swearing at each other is... Well, some of them aren't even swearing. They're just saying words, but the accent.
What was it that I liked? It was your face looks like a BMX track. Yeah, that was a good line.
You got a face like a fucking BMX track.
There was a line in an old adventure game called Normality that I liked, was you've got an ass like a brown sauce bottle. Yeah.
Also, your mum's fanny looks like a
grilled cheese toasty, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Do you like toasties?
Yeah, I like toasties.
You know how there's a...
Coon cheese toastie, because Coon is the best cheese.
I do like Coon as well. I like Becca better, though.
I can't believe they actually named them Coon cheese.
It was a simpler time. You could be racist and no one cared.
They actually did it.
Is it based named after, you know...
No, I don't think so. Because they would have... If it was, surely they would have changed
it. It is old, though. I don't know. You can just... kind of like spotted dick, though, where it just people get used to it, and it just stops being the thing. Do I need to do a mission?
You got a whole T now.
Oh, okay.
Because you teleport escape. Back once you're done.
T. Oh, okay.
You whisk away.
Wait, so I finished that mission?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
And now you're going to go talk to Master Smith, and he's going to be like, okay, good, with this stuff I can do. Oh, yeah, because he's the only black guy he dies
first. Seriously, can we just have one, like, if I ever write a slasher film, I'm intentionally making the black guy live throughout the entire thing, because people would find that funny, even though it's a really easy joke.
Just make sure he has heaps of brushes with death, and he survives, and then somehow someone else inadvertently
make him
done.
Really suicidal, and every time he's like, oh, thank God for this, it's finally coming, and then just something stupid stops it from happening. Have you ever watched, what's it called? Cabin in the Woods?
No.
I'd recommend that, because it's a good, parody. It's not comedic, but it is a good parody.
Oh, those were great weapons.
Huh, cool. Civs. They're fun. A good parody of, deconstruction of the slasher film genre. Do you like slasher films?
I haven't watched slasher films. Yeah. I never, looked at them and thought, that looks fun.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so most of them are... a lot of the early ones actually do try, but they do manage to be fun. I just find some catharsis in twats getting murdered, so... It's always fun. Especially
Isn't Until Dawn technically a slasher film?
Well, it's not a film, it's a game. Well, the odd thing about Until Dawn is it's a slasher game for a bit, and then it has weird monster things. Oh, wait, no, yeah, that's right, I gotta go on missions. It starts as a slasher film, and then it turns out your friend was just, you're very heavily mentally, challenged, well, not challenged, but just destroyed friend is playing a prank, and he didn't actually kill anyone, it was all just set up as fake, and then the rest of the game is just you, trying to survive from these weird, fast, kind of Spider-Man things that jump around and move inhumanly fast, called Wendigos, are based on an old legend thing.
Oh, Wendigo, yeah.
Yeah.
I heard that one.
See, the thing that annoys me about that is that Australia only has the one, traditional monster thing. That's the Bunyip. I like the Bunyip. Well, it is basically just a yeti.
The Aboriginals weren't creative enough with their monsters.
Yeah, no, they had better stories, though. I liked their stories. Like, the one about the
crow. Fucking snake that made the world. Okay,
no,
boy.
I haven't read that one.
The fucking rainbow snake. Holy
shit. I haven't read that one.
It was literally like the snake made the rivers and everything. Because it just slid around the place.
Well, here's
actually, that's probably bastardizing the whole story.
Yeah, probably. Well, it. I don't... I just like that how it... I don't know what it is I like about them. I just think they're interesting. There's one story about the crow where there's a... Once upon a time, old birds were colorless. They all looked like crows. And then one bird clipped its foot on something and they're all trying to help it, but the crow was saying, don't get attached to things because you'll only end up... sorry in the end, because, death and all that. And then the bird ends up exploding with every single other bird around him, and his blood is colourful like rainbows, and that's why the crow is completely black, but all other birds are colourful, because they had compassion, but the crow was bitter, and so he's black and not pretty.
Okay.
I empathise with the crow a lot. Fuck people, they're dickheads.
I remember the story about the emu was like...
I forget the emu one.
It was, I don't know, it used to fly, I think it's actually the fly too close to the sun thing.
So Kid Icarus.
I think it burns himself or something and he can't fly anymore.
Well, what you're thinking of is Kid Icarus. Yeah, Icarus, and the story is,
flies too close to the sun.
His fake wings break because he flew too close to the sun. It's a classic story of bringing a massive ego back down to Earth. It's kind of like why I like Daikatana. Well, not as a game, it's an awful game, but the story, because you know the story of Daikatana, right?
No.
What's his name? John Romero.
What the fuck is that?
It's a sword of Oni.
Holy shit.
Huh, I never
even... There's 90 plus weapons in this game, so I'm seeing shit I've never seen. I played for like 15 hours.
This is all random, isn't it?
Well, they're not randomly made like Borderlands.
It's random drops. It's random, yeah, which weapon you get. It's only Borderlands that really does that. Well, basically, you know John Romero, right? He did Quake and Doom. He got his own studio by basically walking into a room and saying, "Hey, I made Quake and Doom." And then they're like, "Fair enough." So he got his own studio to make his own game. It was called Ion Storm. There was two sections of it. The section that, I forget, it was Ion Storm Dallas and Ion Storm Austin. I forget which one made what, but one of them made Deus Ex, which is called one of the greatest PC games of all time. You wholeheartedly disagree, as we well know. And the other one, which John Romero was leading, made Daikatana, which took 3 years, which at the time was a bit ridiculous, because he was like, oh, it's going to be out in 7 months. But he was basically being a massive dick about it at the time as well. He's like, oh, this is going to be an amazing game, you're all going to love it. That was close. And he was leading a kind of rock star lifestyle, almost. And it was like buying new studios and shit when he should have been working on the game. Then Daikatana came out 3 years later, and it was fucking atrocious, and nobody trusted John... Oh, wait, that's a rabbit.
I was like, hang on, why are you doing this again?
Nobody trusted him anymore, because it was a shit game. I might get you to play that one day, just as a... just so you can see.
Just a piece of
history.
Half
the weapons in that game had a weird, just, tendency to kill you. Like, there was this one weapon that was like a bowl that would, like... it would move around, but it would almost certainly hit you and kill you instantly. It was weird.
Oh, go to your... turn around. There's the... to get the cookie.
Cookie. Oh, it's a fortune cookie. To lose one parent may be regarded as a misfortune. To lose both looks like carelessness. I like that quote. Because, although... Oscar Wilde's kind of cool. I like Oscar Wilde. It's not bad. Anyway, well, how much longer have we got? Oh, we can wrap it up in about like 5 minutes, actually. Is there anything else you wanted to talk about specifically?
No, I mean, yeah.
What would you do?
Kind of a bludge episode.
What would you do to improve this game?
I don't know.
I would take out a lot of the faff in this game. Although it's not bad, it's quite fun. Oh god, I haven't died once though. I'd probably make it harder if it was me. Speak of the devil.
I played on a difficulty above just because I saw you can get better loot.
Fair enough.
And you do need it, but then I don't know. It made the enemies really quite some made some of them ridiculously bullet spongy, like some of the bosses.
Yeah,
like, I'd charge up like full. I had the double barrel shotgun, and I gemmed it in a way so I pretty much made it so it was all about just one shot. One shot, all the damage.
One shot, one kill.
So I was putting out, like, you know, and then charging it up as well to unleash, like, you know, an instant kill. And even then, it took, like, you know, 20 of those to kill bosses.
This is working. Ah, oh, bottlenecking him. Bait, retreat, beat, repeat. It's a classic.
Hang on, if you right-click with the sword, actually, and you push... depending on which way you move, like, if you move to the left, then it will do a side one, but if you do it...
yeah.
If you forward, it'll, do a stab.
What's your favourite old-timey, first-person shooter?
What do you mean by old-timey?
Well, you know, what's one of your favourite old retro first-person shooters?
Half-Life count?
Yeah, that counts. Oh. It is 2000. Okay, I'll say that's the edge. Nothing past Half-Life.
Oh, yeah, because nothing's better than Half-Life.
You're saying Half-Life is your favorite game of all time?
Well, I mean, in terms
I of like Half-Life timing. As well. It's one of my favorites. I really like Doom though. Doom is a fun game, and Duke Nukem 3D. Although there were a few samey levels in that game, if I'm being honest.
I've actually played Doom. Does that surprise you?
No.
Oh,
everyone's played Doom. It's like, you can play it online for free if you want. I didn't, because I want to support the developers, because they... They actually seem to act with artistic passion, because they released new levels for the old Quake games.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
And I was like, huh, there's no reason to do that, because it's an old game that's not that expensive, so you're not going to get a lot of people with that. That's not really much of an advertising thing. And, interesting.
Alright, you want to list good developers to wrap it off? Developers you think are actually, like, good people in general?
You know what's funny? My mind jumped to Valve, but they're not even really developers anymore, aren't they? They're Steam.
I'd say they're probably more...
they're Steam.
I'd say they're more producers than anything.
Oh, yeah, but they haven't produced anything in the last 3 years.
Well, you know, Source Engine, they toss that around for...
You think maybe they're just somehow really good at hiding things? I'd like to believe that that's the case, but I don't know, something tells me that it's not, like, you know, realistic thinking, which is kind of what I pride myself on. Fucking just, weapon wheel, what was it? Yeah, that. Oh, I'm out of bullets. Fucking hell, I've only got a shotgun. Huh, well, whatever.
I'd say CD Projekt Red's pretty good as well.
Yeah!
Mainly because of the way they handled downloadable content for The Witcher 3. Lots of little shit like one quest or an outfit or some extra finisher moves, all free. But the biggest stuff, like actual full-on expansions, then, yeah, that was,
I liked how their solution to the fact that games aren't taken seriously unless they're, like new graphics up the arse is by basically just working their bollocks off and... till they have something incredibly massive that shouldn't be possible to make, but they somehow managed to make it. And I was saying how Just Cause 3, they should have worked, like... what they should do is have worked on some good gore physics and made it basically the Witcher 3 of just dumb, violent games. I think it should be. Just go crazy with all of the physics, because what were we doing?
Yeah, we hooked someone in the head with one of the grappling hooks and attached him to the ceiling. Then dragged him up a little bit, and he's like, you know, flopping about like, ow. There's a hook in my brain, but I'm still alive. Then I hooked onto his,
am I done?
Yeah, you hooked him. Yeah, okay. You're done the mission. Then I hooked onto his leg, and I was trying to drag him to the ground and see if I could rip him in half. If they got gore in that game...
Yeah, that would have been great if that happened. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to talk to this dude, and then only use my sword, and then see how long I last until I die. And then that'll be a good conclusion. Fuck, yeah, it's, yeah, I have this crude for you?
Yeah.
Crud for you?
Crude.
What's... crude's an adjective. Isn't that... is crude a thing? Is crude a noun?
It's shorthand for, like, crude oil.
Ah, okay. Yeah, that's a thing. Skip all these, probably, these cutscenes that somebody probably spent a lot of time on. Don't care.
Someone probably spent a lot of time modelling all those weapons that you'll never see.
Well, all in all, this game's not too bad. Is that guy taking a selfie?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Look how wacky we are. He's even using the selfie stick.
Well, he's like totes randoms, dude.
Yeah.
What's a good comedy game? Saints Row.
Yeah, Saints Row.
That's the correct answer.
Saints Row is pretty good.
Saints Row 4. Was,
I don't know. I'm not that fond of 4.
Well, I think that's right. Fun,
but I mean, I like 3 more.
Maybe really? Because
I don't think they get a lot of credit for it. And in fact, of all the people who brought it up, the Good Game Review brought it up, they use licensed music really well in that game.
Yeah, I watched the opening of Saints Row 4. What was it, the Kanye song that they used?
No, for 3. Yeah, they used Power 3. When you're like...
Yeah, that works. Like, yeah, that works well.
Yeah, that beat, and you just... Yeah, and that's when you're about to jump up with a helicopter on top of the penthouse. Oh, man.
What's your favorite soundtrack?
Oh, bruh.
Hotline Miami?
Yeah, Hotline Miami, obviously.
Undertale is a really good soundtrack.
I've heard it. It's alright. It's better than fucking Crypt of the Necro Dancer.
That was a good one, too. Not as good as Undertale, but it...
I'll give you that one. I'll give you that. I'll stop memeing Undertale. I'll give you that. The soundtrack's actually pretty good.
Yeah. Like, the Megalovania is basically the only thing that got me through the Sans fight. So other than sheer determination. Get it? Because determination is the thing.
Oh, yeah, he's gonna grow really big.
Oh, hello. Hello. What the hell did I just
that's
do?
That's a special ability. If you hold right click.
Oh, I didn't even know.
Well, that's one
Beyblade, Beyblade.
No, you can charge it up.
Oh, okay.
So if you hold it longer. That one's a stab, yeah. though. You got the stab instead.
Oh. Yeah, whatever.
You missed. Now they're looking at you like, what a fucking retard.
Heal me.
We're giant mutants, but he's the retard.
Fucking mutant crabs. They should make, like, undersea creatures enemies in games more often, because there's some fucking weird shit on there.
Yeah.
It was like, there's only one game I can think of that really did it. It was like some shitty Resident Evil ripoff called, and not the good Resident Evil 4, it was Resident Evil 1. What was it called? It was, Blue Stinger? That's it, Blue Stinger. I just looked that up, it was on the Dreamcast.
Oh.
I like the Dreamcast. That was the last console to have a decent name. We're gonna cast for some motherfucking dreams. The rest of them is like just frat bro names, like the Xbox, yeah. And then there's the PlayStation, which is generic.
You know why they call it the Xbox 360?
Why?
Because you look at it and then you turn 360 degrees and walk away.
But doesn't that just mean that you'll be looking at the Xbox when you walk away? I don't get that meme. I don't understand.
You don't understand memes in general.
No, I don't. They're weird and foreign, and I don't get them.
Just because they're foreign doesn't mean they're bad.
No.
This is coming from
no,
me.
No, they're foreign in... Oh, I got my fists out for a second. Oh, I miss the days where once upon a time, instead of having a melee button, every first-person shooter would just have its iconic melee weapon, like the boot in Duke Nukem 3D, the pitchfork in Blood, and the crowbar in Half-Life.
I can't believe you didn't say the painkiller in Painkiller.
Well, yeah, well, because that wasn't strictly melee, you could also shoot that thing.
Yeah.
Although that was a great weapon. There's a lot of good weapons in that game, like the shuriken lightning gun, the gun that shoots entire tree logs at people. That's great. Nice.
You know Hanzo does that as well.
No, that's a stick. He shoots sticks at people.
No, he shoots logs. Have you seen the hitbox? He shoots
logs.
Yeah,
fair enough. Where the hell is everyone? Oh, fuck, I'm never gonna die.
You can't even kill yourself.
Which is unrealistic for a Japanese game. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay, we're done. Just...
Okay.
Do you remember how to close this video properly?
Okay, let's end on a joke. Give me a parameter.
What do you call
two Scottish
people playing Call of Duty?
I don't know, Nathan. What do you call two Scottish people playing Call of Duty?
A YouTube channel with more subscribers than us. It's over now. You can stop, you can alt tab.
Bye, guys.